Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time.
Morning. Ira Epstein,
like
of Linn
more
Associates
of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key
Wednesday,
on your
6th
video
of December 2017, 9:15 a.m., or just past it, actually. As you can see, we're still in the thralls of the stock market break, if you will, the correction. Now, I wrote last night, if you get my my consultancy letter, and it says very clearly that there could be reasons. People might just want to grab a great year. Money managers that get paid a percentage of what they made on a yearly basis don't want to blow it. You're already December 6th. People start looking and saying, hey, you know, I'm going away for the Christmas holiday. Why do I want to gamble on what's going to happen with the tax situation in the U.S.? Today's report on Jerusalem, where the U.S. is about to say that it recognizes Jerusalem as the capital of Israel. What's behind that? A lot of us are questioning. Why create the problem when you don't have one? So there's things of that nature. Gold might may be getting a small bit off of that. Copper most certainly isn't. And silver isn't. The copper market, this is probably more of a reactionary bounce than anything else. And when I do the metal report in the afternoon, you'll see where the Bollinger Bands come in and why you're getting some of those. Still, extended weakness in the grain market. They just can't hold the rallies. There's no follow-through, be it to the upside or downside, in the corn or the wheat. Beans, I can't yet say that, but it's certainly not acting like a market that wants to run. Remember I told you I didn't know which way that sugar was going, and now we know. It broke out to the downside. And we had terrible numbers last night on the API in terms of builds and distillates and gasoline stocks. And if the EIA numbers at 9:30 come out anything like that, well, we'll see if you can get down to the $55 a barrel level, I guess. When we take a look at the day's data, a positive. The Conference Board U.S. Online Help Wanted Index up to 137.1, prior month 81.5. Now, the third quarter, a revised non-farm productivity and unit labor cost headlines came out, and they came out at 3%. They expected 3.3, so not quite as good on the productivity. The labor cost was up 0.2, actually down 0.2, I'm sorry. They expected it up 0.3. That is one of the reasons I think you're getting the bonds and notes rallying here. Where is that wage labor inflation? We're not really seeing it. ADP's numbers came out and they were up 190,000. They expected 175. So you'll get people saying, oh, the market's labor market's hot. I agree from that perspective. But you're not getting people having to pay more to hire those people. Germany's October industrial orders rose for the third month, up 0.5% compared to the 3% decline they were looking for. Orders are picking up across Europe. That is something you've got to keep your eye on. Generally speaking, a lot of world economies are still doing well. However, there's a rotation, this profit. The Nikkei fell about 2% earlier this morning. Hang Seng down about the same. Taiwan and South Korea's indexes were shedding 1.5%. And South Korea's has had one of the bigger declines of the year, actually. Bank of Canada just moments ago announced they're keeping their policy rate unchanged, but they always say that they can change it, they can get more aggressive if the labor market warrants it, and they said the labor market is doing better, slowly, but definitely doing better. Here's something important. The head of Monsanto's Brazil operation said the 2017-18 summer corn crop, remember what time of the year they're at, they're at the other hemisphere, the summer corn crop may decline by 20-30%. That's world prices are so low that there's not a lot of incentive. And in Brazil, a lot of the farmers also don't use the type of farming techniques that we do. I'm talking fertilizer, everything you put into the soil to make the crops better. Then there's the question of GMO as well. So you always look at that. I want to remind you that Modern Trader magazine, they've come out with their January edition. So if you're interested in receiving this edition, it's pretty interesting. When you take a look, this is what it is this year for the January. It's market makers and shakers for 2017. Gives you an idea of what they're talking. But as usual, it's going to cover a whole range of things. You're going to get from individual stocks, ETFs, derivatives. You're going to talk corn and cattle in it. You're going to talk the yen at this point in time in it as well. Then you get to the technical stories, chart patterns, the fantag patterns. They're adding, actually, here, two more stocks to the FANG stocks, and they call it fantag. So it gives you an idea as to what that part is about. And you can hear, see, tech stocks, energy appear volatile. Interesting. Gives you an idea of the pictures, what they're doing. Here you go with the other stock patterns that are moving on with it. They're adding Amazon, another one of the stocks that they're talking. Google's in there, of course. So you get all these different plays. How do you get this magazine? And it is a $79 a year value, along with their daily market focus reports. It all comes by email. Just give us a call, go to our website, sign up for it there. It's on the front page. You can click up here if you're watching me on YouTube or underneath us on many websites. It says click here for Ira's free information. I'm Ira Epstein. I'll see you this afternoon. Remember, there is no morning update like this going to be on Thursday. I'll be out of the office. See you all later this afternoon.